give us your backstory. It's fascinating.
There's so much involved, but long story short is, you know, when I came over, I spoke Italian. I had trouble speaking English, so didn't do well in school, definitely didn't public speak, and had a very old school Italian upbringing. So I was not allowed out. I was monitored every second of the day. I was never allowed to be home alone until I was 22. So I lived in a nice little bubble, but my bubble burst when my grandmother had a pulmonary embolism doing the bed, because if the bed wasn't done in our house, then the room was a mess. So she was in ICU for a number of months and was told that she would never be able to even stand. And I was getting married in 4 months. And I just bought an apartment, or I just rented an apartment for my first time. I was moving out of her house. And I got fired that week because they thought that I was leaving for this New Jersey Elder Law Center with one of the partners. And I, in fact, wasn't. So I'm pretty confident in that if I didn't jump off the George Washington at that point in my life, I'm pretty set for the rest of it. So I just happened to fall into what we do professionally. And now it's my, like Carrie said, it's my why. I've lived the story of a caregiver, and it's a tough part of life. And my mission is to help people, women in particular, because, you know, we're a unique breed. We're looking to always be perfect and always be there for everyone and not necessarily be there for ourselves. So I want to help women, especially let them know that they can have it all, just not all at once.
Yeah. Well, one thing, Clelia is very modest. So the connection between her and her grandmother, obviously outside of blood, is her grandmother really was her primary caretaker. Her dad, Clelia's dad, took off when she was 3 years old, and didn't come back. And so Clelia established a bond with her grandmother, perhaps deeper than even that sort of bond that you automatically have with your grandparents.